I haven't been down there since 1953. No, it had nothing to do with Eisenhower. No, it's a cellar down there. It's very damp, clammy. You don't want to go down there. Trust me. You'd get sick. Suffocating. Very nauseating. The smell of the clamminess and the mildew and everything? Woo! Smells unbearable. Gets in your clothes. No, there was no accident down there. It didn't blow up or catch on fire or anything. It wasn't so dramatic. I mean, well, never mind. No, never mind. I can't talk to you about this. What's a smart girl like you going around talking to old ladies about the down there's for? We didn't do this sort of thing when I was a girl. What? Jesus, okay. There was this boy, Andy Leftcoff. He was cute. Well, I thought so. And tall, like me. And I really liked him. He asked me out for a date in his car. I can't do this. I can't tell you this, talk about down there. You just know it's there. Like the cellar. There's rumbles down there sometimes, and you can hear the pipes, and things get caught there, little animals and things. And it gets wet, and sometimes people have to plug up the leaks. Otherwise, the door stays closed. You forget about it. I mean, it's a part of the house, but you don't see it or think about it. It has to be there, though, because every house needs a cellar. Otherwise, the bedroom would be in the basement. Oh, Andy. Andy Leftcoff, right. Andy was a catch. That's what we called it in my day. He asked me out for a date in his new white Chevy Bel Air. I was thinking that my legs were too long for the seats. I have long legs. I was just looking at my big kneecaps smushed up against the dashboard when Andy just kissed me in this surprisingly take me by control like they do in the movie sort of way. And, well, I got excited. So excited. And there was a flood down there. I couldn't control it. It was like this force of passion, this river of life just flooded out of me. Right through my panties, right onto the car seat of his new white Chevy Bel Air. It wasn't pee, and it was smelly. Well, frankly, I didn't really smell anything at all, but he said, Andy said, that it smelled like sour milk, and it was staining his car seat. I was a stinky, weird girl, he said. I wanted to explain that his kiss had caught me off guard, that I wasn't normally like this. I tried to wipe the flood up with my dress. It was a new yellow primrose dress, and it looked so ugly with the flood on it. Andy drove me home without saying another word, and when I got out and closed his car door, I closed the whole store. Locked it, never opened for business again. I dated some after that, but the idea of flooding made me too nervous. I never even got close again. I used to have dreams. Crazy dreams. Oh, they're dopey. Why? Burt Reynolds. I don't know why. He never did much for me in life, but in my dreams, it was always Bert and I, Bert and I, Bert and I. It was always the same general dream. We'd be out, Bert and I, at one of those restaurants, like the kind you see in Atlantic City, all big with chandeliers and stuff, and thousands of waiters with the vests. Bert would hand me an orchid corsage. I'd pin it on my blazer. We'd laugh. We were always laughing, Bert and I. Laughing, laughing. We'd eat shrimp cocktail. Huge shrimp. Fabulous shrimp. We laughed some more. We were very happy together. And then Bert would pull me to him in the middle of the restaurant, and just as he was about to kiss me, the restaurant would start to shake. Pigeons would fly out from under the tables. I don't know what those pigeons were doing there. And the flood would come straight from down there. It would pour out of me. It would pour and pour. There would be fish inside it and little boats. And the whole restaurant would fill up with my flood. And Bert would be standing there, waist deep in it, looking horribly disappointed in me that I'd done it again. Horrified as he watched his friends, Dean Martin and the like, swim past us in their tuxedos and evening gowns. I don't have those dreams anymore. Not since they took away just about everything connected with down there. Moved out the uterus, the tubes, the whole works. The doctor thought he was being funny. He told me, if you don't use it, you'll lose it. But really, I found out it was cancer. Everything around it had to go. Who needs it anyway? Highly overrated. I've done other things. I love the dog shows. I sell antiques. You ask me what it would wear? What kind of a question is that? What would it wear? It would wear a big sign, closed due to flooding. What would it say? I told you, it's not like that. It's not like a person who speaks. It stopped being a thing that talked a long time ago. It's a place. A place you don't go. It's closed up, under the house. It's down there. You happy? You made me talk. You got it out of me. You got an old lady to talk about her down there. You know, actually, you're the first person I've ever told about this. And I feel a little better.